Hello, dear friends. The first attempts to create flying aircraft carriers were not much younger than aviation itself. As early as 1916, the Porter Baby flying boat was built in Great Britain. This large three-propeller aircraft designed for reconnaissance could also be used as a bomber. But because of its huge size, low speed, and limited maneuverability, the Porter Baby was an easy target for German pilots. The idea to secure the plane was fantastic. A light fighter Bristol Scout was specially placed on the upper wing of the Porter Baby. In May 1916, the Bristol Scout fighter successfully detached from its carrier. Despite the recorded ability to take off from the air, further tests were suspended and the Porter Baby flying boats were decommissioned. The next stage in the development of flying aircraft carriers became not large planes, but airships. From 1918 onward, attempts were made around the world, with varying results. The aim was to use airships as air bases for aircraft. During World War I, tests were conducted by the Germans and the British. It was the Germans who managed to launch the Albatross D-3 biplane fighter from one of their Zeppelin airships in 1918. After the end of the First World War, the German project was cancelled. But the idea of using airships as flight bases for aircraft was developed by the Americans. Thus, in 1930s, the first attempts were made in the United States not only to take off, but also to land in the sky, which was quite difficult to accomplish. The problem was solved with the help of hooks, which attached the plane to special structural elements. In the USSR, however, experiments were conducted with heavy bombers TB-3 and small single-engine fighters Polikarpov I-16. This project was called Zvenua. It is worth noting that the planes that took off from the flying aircraft carrier would not only provide protection for the flying aircraft carrier, but could also act as independent small bombers capable of hitting point targets. Between 1941 and 1942, the Zvenua project flew about 30 combat sorties. But when the Germans' Mi-909s appeared in the air, the TB-3 proved to be too easy a target, and these planes could do little to counter Messerschmitts. In the early 1970s, the US developed a concept that envisioned one Boeing 747 carrying up to 7 projected microfighter aircraft. As conceived, the microfighters were to carry a wide range of weapons, allowing them to engage both air and ground targets. The upper deck of the Boeing 747 flying aircraft carrier project was intended for a hangar, and below there was a takeoff and landing deck from which the planes were to take off. The US Air Force leadership was very pleased with the project under development, but it was not implemented due to the huge cost of the project. And what happens nowadays? With the rapid development of drones, drone manufacturers talk about the possibility of creating flying aircraft carriers for them in the not-too-distant future. Airborne aircraft carriers deliver drones to a combat zone and a swarm of drones fly out of it, capable of hitting any target. It may seem like science fiction now, but once upon a time, the flight of a man soaring through the skies was considered a fairy tale. That's all for today. If you enjoyed the video, please support it with your likes and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. See you all later!